The Hackspace is a community workshop. There's lots of them all over the world. Nottingham is probably one of the biggest, if not the biggest, in the UK. Basically, we have a whole load of tools that people can use for their hobbies or even businesses. It's the sort of thing that you perhaps couldn't have to afford to have in your garage or don't have the space for that. But this is somewhere where you can join and get access to those sort of facilities. We're totally run by members. We don't have any members of staff. So it's all run by volunteers, and we rely on their membership fees for buying new tools and equipment and stuff. We've run various workshops here, all sorts of things. Some are craft related, jewellery related, but quite a lot of computer related workshops. We've had Raspberry Pi workshops. I actually run the Arduino workshops along with another Hackspace member. And those are really good for people to just sort of get over the initial hurdle of getting started with the Arduino. So, you know, if you buy an Arduino board, it's often, there's a certain hurdle you need to get over to get started. But if you come along to one of our workshops, we've got a program all planned out where you don't have to have any previous knowledge of programming or electronics, and we'll get you started with that. Get you started flashing LED, as most electronics projects and software projects that involve embedded circuits start with. And then we work through various bits of programming circuits through to controlling the speed of a motor with something called pulse width modulation.
People at Hackspace have helped us out with videos. Our very first computer file video was the Defender clone that Michael has made, the vending machine. Rob Miles is obviously an active member of the Hackspace, and he's done a lot of videos here. James has done some things on the Arduino for us. Spencer has done some things on the Z80.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we've got about 640 members, so I'm sure you've got many more you could fill there. Shall we go for a wander around?
I think the building we're in was actually an old lace building, but there's now lots of little businesses in here, lots of band practice rooms, so there might be a bit of noise as we go past certain areas. This is the main entrance, Nottingham Hackspace, and we've got RFID cards for getting in. So after you come through the street door, put your card in front of here. We've got Hello Ian, and then the door is unlocked, and we can get in. So welcome to Nottingham Hackspace. That's all based on Arduino, and behind the scenes there's some code and obviously a MySQL database with all the details of the RFID cards. We have quite an active software team sort of behind the scenes that have writing all of our membership system, and we're currently running a HMS1 system, Hackspace Management System 1. They're working on version 2 at the moment, rewriting it all in PHP with a Laravel framework. This is what we call our comfy area. Over this side we've got a museum of outdated technology. So we've got a Commodore PET up there.
I think that's been in the background of a video or two.
It probably has. We've got quite a few members who are interested in retro computing, so you could probably do a separate video on them at some stage. Some time ago, when we were trying to raise a few more funds for moving into our new area downstairs, we had some fundraising events, and someone said, why not do a sort of talking donations box that collects a little bit of money? And if you put a coin in...
10 pence, no good, try again.
That was actually a 2p that I put in. It has no idea what you put in, it's just a simple coin sensor that's in there. It's based on a Raspberry Pi, which takes a coin going in and just says a random phrase. It sometimes makes announcements trying to solicit money off visitors, particularly on a Wednesday open night. But you'll find all sorts of odd things like this around the Hackspace.
This time try another amount.
This is an old LDSL modem that you can see the Raspberry Pi there that's been fitted into. There's a little amplifier circuit to get the sound out. When if you press the button on it,
it
replays the last message. If you press it enough times, it gives up.
This time, try another amount. Please stop pressing the button.
Okay, so we have all sorts of equipment that people get access to. So this is actually a computer-controlled embroidery machine. So members can do designs at home, bring their design in a memory stick, use the software on this computer to convert into the right format to do the embroidery on this machine. There's a number of machines that you need to do an induction with us before you can gain access. And we record who's done the training through the RFID access system. So if I put my card in there, it'll just say not inducted, and I won't be able to turn the machine on because I've not done the training. But if someone else comes in who has done the training, they can put the card in here, they can turn the machine on, and they can obviously use it. All of this has been made in-house by members. Again, it's based on an Arduino, an RFID card reader, and then we've got a laser cut box. Over that area, we've got lots of crafts and art materials, lots of textile materials that's is of interest to some members. We also have another group of members who look after these vending machines. So we've now got two vending machines. This particular one has featured in a computer file video before. And it's all on the same RFID access system as the machines and the doors.
Last time we came, that was full of bits of electronics.
Yeah, it used to be, but we found that the foodstuff sells better and brings a bit more money into the hack space. In this area, we've got woodworking tools. So in this area, we've got all of the dusty woodworking tools. So we've got a big table saw here, and we've got a couple of members over there using the planer thicknesser. So here we've got our laser cutter. This is used for cutting acrylic, plywood, MDF. It will also cut paper, card, leather. It will engrave glass, it will engrave slates. We do get a lot of people joining just to get access to this machine, because this is not the sort of thing you could have in your garage at home, or not unless you've got lots of space and lots of money. These cost about £6,000. As soon as it powers up, the head will auto-date them in the corner over there. Makes quite a lot of noise. The noise is actually the extractor. So the extractor is running to suck all the smoke that's in here out of the way. Okay, so this is the software we use. It works using DXF files. I'm just going to quickly import a file. There's a little bit of tidying up we need to do on this file, because it comes in as a number of separate points here, and then we can send it down to the laser cutter. Once we put the appropriate powers and speeds in, and then the laser cutter will cut the part out. So in this area, we've got our metalwork tools. We've got band saws for cutting metalwork. We have a lathe if anyone wants to do metal turning. We've got a Bridgeport milling machine, and at the back we've got welding equipment. We've got MIG welder and a TIG welder. And over this side here, we've got an automated hacksaw. So you can, if you've got a large piece of metal to cut up, there's no need to do it by hand. This is a nice parallel cut. You can put your metal in here, and it saws through and then turns itself off when it's finished. These old railway clocks have come from the workplace of one of our members. So one of them there we've got running with the time on it. We've not got this one running at the moment. So Nottingham Hackspace is currently on two floors, and they're both one's directly below the other. But unfortunately, it's a bit of a walk around to get between the two levels. But eventually, we hope to have enough money to be able to put in our own staircase, our own lift, even between the two floors. Okay, so this is our new area, and in this area here, we've got some more computer-controlled equipment. So we've got a computer-controlled milling machine here. We had someone just recently making some parts for guitars on here, which looked fantastic. And over the far end, we've got a computer-controlled lathe, and in the middle, we've got a 3D printer.
Do they get so much use then?
No, the computer-controlled milling machine and the computer-controlled lathe don't get an awful lot of use. And I think the problem with that is that we don't have any induction programs for those. So if you want to use those, you've got to do a lot of reading up, a lot of self-training, perhaps watching YouTube videos to learn how to draw the parts and then to get from the parts through to the tool paths for cutting them out. And this computer might be a bit dated, but it's powerful enough to run this lathe. So all of the lighting in this new area is computer controlled. We've got Arduinos running the show down here. It's all in this control box, and there's actually a web interface you can use to turn on individual lights in this area. I didn't develop this, it's all done by another member. So we can turn individual lights on and off. So if I just select one in here, I'm not sure which one it is, but one of the lights will go off if I do that. Yeah, it's one over there. Anyway, quite a few members didn't particularly like having to go to a website to turn the lighting on and off. Whilst it's a great use of technology, some people didn't like that. So we had one member who built a light switch. Whilst it looks like an ordinary light switch, it's just got a USB power supply type going into there. We've actually got a processor in there. We've got an ESP826 processor with a bit of software running, which goes to the right web page to turn the lights on and off. We're a not-for-profit organisation. If anyone's looking to find a hackspace, then there's a couple of good websites to take a look at. One is wiki.hackerspaces.org, where you can find hackspaces all over the world. If you're in the UK, is www.hackspace.org.uk. And they've got lists of all the UK hackspaces on there.